Hello everyone, may God bless all of you, and the Holy Spirit may guide you into all truth so that you can make the right choices. Praise God. Let me just deactivate the comments. All right. So now we can go. So let us read and see the greatness of faith. This is the intelligent faith, a faith that is rational, a faith that thinks, not an emotional faith, but a faith that feels. No, the faith that feels or emotional is unuseful, unworthy. But in the intelligent faith, this faith comes from the Holy Spirit. The faith that feels is a faith that is emotional, that comes from the heart. And is that faith that is not sustained and does not sustain when tribulation, the desert, comes. But once a person has an intelligent faith, when they have a rational faith, a faith that thinks, it is a supernatural faith because it comes from the Holy Spirit. So when a person has the intelligent faith, a supernatural faith, a rational faith, an intelligent faith, this person, they are based upon the Word of God, which is the fountain of their life, the Word of God. And whenever they lose, for example, a family member, when they lose a loved one, if that loved one was righteous, a person of God, living in faith, then they have the comfort. They have the comfort of the Holy Spirit. Not only the comfort, a spiritual comfort, but they also have the comfort from the Word of the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit says, it says clearly, it is written in Isaiah 57, reads verse 1, says like this: the righteous perishes. The righteous perishes. Which is to die in the world is death, is known as death. It's like to say, the righteous died. And no man takes it to heart. No man takes it to heart that that person was of God and that person was transferred to the kingdom of heaven. They were here in God's kingdom here on earth, but now when they pass away, once dead, they go to the kingdom of heaven. But people that live in this world, they do not consider it like this because they don't understand. They cannot understand the idea of the heavens because they live for this world. They live their lives based on lies, on a kingdom of deceit, the kingdom of unbelief, the kingdom of disorder. And that is the reason why they do not consider that righteous person before God's eyes, they were transferred or promoted to the kingdom of heaven. So it continues saying, the righteous perishes, and no man takes it to heart. Merciful men are taken away. So the righteous who perish are people, they are of those who are merciful. Who are merciful and they are taken away. They are taken away. This is very interesting. They are taken away while no one considers that the righteous is taken away from evil. This is wonderful. This is a blessing. This is a glorious word. So, you that you lost a loved one, and they were of God, that they confessed Jesus Christ as their Lord, as their God, that throughout their life, in the last days, they put God first as the only one in their life, the only Lord. So then this person, when they pass away, or when they go to eternity, they are actually taken away. They are taken away from evil. They are taken away from evil. Just as an example, we are in the last days. We are living in moments. We are drawing near to the end of times. And the Holy Scripture guarantees that Jesus, He comes to take His church, to take the faithful, to take those who are righteous. And this is the rapture. The rapture will happen before evil takes over. Before evil takes over, meaning worse scenario, God will take His people, those who believe in Him and lived according to His word, according to the discipline of God. So these will be taken in a twinkling of an eye. And that is the rapture. And when a person dies, we can put it this way, in a clear way, understanding way, because no one dies. Nobody dies. But people, they are separated from their loved ones. Who are separated from their loved ones and they lived a righteous life here. So then the ones who are left, the righteous, they are comforted. They are comforted by this word here, that the righteous perishes, but they were taken away from evil. This is how we believe. Sometimes a person is of God and they die young. And then their loved ones normally think, wow, but they were still young. They still had years ahead. When God takes away, when God takes away, He retrieves them, you know, whoever it is, anyone. But He takes them away from evil. So this person who was righteous, they were taken away from evil. So they were drawn to the kingdom of heaven. Of course, that those who live by the glory of this world, those who have this world as their God, those who live in function of this world, they do not understand what we are saying. For them, they died. They died young, my goodness. But to God, in God's eyes, the righteous is taken before or taken away from evil. So I lost my mother, my father. I loved them, and I lost brothers as well. And yet I believe that they are better than us because they have been taken away to God. And when you read this verse of Isaiah 57, check it. Check on it. I will leave it here. The righteous perishes, and no man takes it to heart. Merciful men are taken away, while no one considers that the righteous is taken away from evil. And then there is another verse, the second one, it says, he shall enter into peace. So the righteous perishes, and he shall enter into peace. They shall rest in their beds, each one walking in his uprightness. So they shall rest in their beds, each one walking in his uprightness. So you can see that when a person has their faith upon God's word, which is the intelligent faith, they have the blessing of God's word, the blessing of the Holy Spirit, and they have the assurance of their loved one in the kingdom of heaven. And they will be together soon as well. And when a person is faithful to God, they are separated from this world and they enter into a divine world. They enter in the kingdom of heaven. And when a person dies without fearing God, without putting the Lord Jesus, making the Lord Jesus their Lord and Savior, they are also separated, but they will enter in the world of hell, in the world in which it is reserved for the devil and his demons. So this is the world of those after death, the world for those who have not followed the Lord Jesus as the Lord and Savior. People put religion before God. People put their faith in idols. Religion, a true religion, is this, to believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. He said, whoever believes in me and is baptized shall be saved. So they have the guarantee of entering in God's presence. But those who don't are condemned. They are condemned. That is the word. So therefore, it is good for you to check your faith so that you may not be practicing a religion just by following what others say, without objective or purpose, without having this loyalty, a faith that remains. Because when a person has their faith upon God's word, it is written that God, through the Holy Spirit, comforts this person. So if you lost a loved one, somebody that you really loved, and this person, they were of God, so you are comforted. You may cry because you miss that person, but you're not going to cry of anguish. You're not going to cry because never again. No, you're not going to be sad. You are going to cry because you miss them, because you were separated. They did not die because they don't die. Because Jesus himself said, whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Shall never die. And I say this for those who do not understand what it means, eternity, what means eternal life, so that these can understand and have an idea of what happens to those who are righteous and they are taken away from evil. They are taken away from evil before evil takes over. So then God, preserving their life, takes them away. All right? So this is the truth that sets one free. Because either you are or you're not of God. There is no in-between or halfway. Either you are or you are not. Is yes, yes, and no, no. Jesus is the truth. He is the truth. And that's it. And with Him is yes, yes, and no, no. Those who believe in Him and is baptized will be saved. And those who don't will be condemned. And we cannot do nothing. And each one has the choice. It's a personal decision. Maybe you are that person that you are so concerned or so worried with conquering things in this world, and you do not even see that life is passing by. And you did not take yet the most important decision, which is your relationship with God through the Lord Jesus Christ. We speak a lot about the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of joy, the Spirit of peace, of eternal life. And you want to receive the Holy Spirit so that you can enjoy life in this world? No, it's not going to work. The Holy Spirit, He comes to guide us into all truth, to guide us, to lead us, to give us guidance, and to guide our thoughts so that we can make the right choices and that we can eat the fruits of obedience. All right? So God bless all of you, and until tomorrow, in Jesus' name, praise God.